about fire. It's a story about division, and it's a story about discernment. And as the confirmation candidates will tell you, the importance of a story lies in its context. And so let's just take a brief step backwards and look at the context in which Jesus speaks the story of fire, division, and discernment. For those of you that were here last week, do you remember that we took a little pebble and I asked you to keep it in your pocket? If you lost it, there's more at the back of the church. And if you were not here last week, I encourage you to take one at the back of the church. The purpose of this pebble was to help us on our journey from fear to faith. From fear to faith. And today, Jesus is speaking about that journey from fear to faith. That in that journey, a fire will be kindled on the inside of you. That in that journey, as that fire burns and as it refines you, it may lead you into times of separation with the way things used to be, and that may not be comfortable. And it will require great discernment on your behalf to know how to follow that path. So let's see what the readings today give us as a helpful signage along this journey from fear to faith. In Jeremiah, we read about the deep division that is created between Jeremiah and the leadership of the day. And we read of that division for chapters and chapters and chapters before we get to the portion from this morning, where God finally enters the conversation. And in this, God says to the leadership of the day, "You are losing the plot. You have lost your way, and you are leading God's people in the wrong direction. Only Jeremiah understands my heart, and yet you refuse to listen to him. And so I am going to be like a fire." Now, this notion of fire in Scripture can often be thought of only as the fire of judgment. But in fact, God uses this idea of fire very often. We see it in the burning bush that Moses sees in the wilderness so that he is called. It is a fire that does not consume, but it is a fire that does refine. It is a fire that burns away all that is not of God in us. It is a passion that God has to engulf us, to renew us, to release us from the many prisons that enchain us. Now, as we sit here today, celebrating and praying for those who minister to people in prisons, we might think that we are only talking about a specialized ministry out there. But in fact, we are not. Each and every one of us is enchained by something. We are prisoners of some lie that has been told to us that we have come to believe, that creates fear in us, fear of failure, fear of rejection, fear of being fully who we are, fear of loss. And these prisons that bind us, we are required to minister to one another to release us from that. This is a process, it is a journey of coming to a true understanding of who we are made to be in Christ. And it is a difficult one, my friends. But God says in his word today that he is passionate that you are enough, that you do not have to be afraid, that you can believe. And as we are released from these lies and these negative ideas about who we are or who we should be, as we are released from this judgment and we start living in the fullness of the inheritance we have in Christ, as we step into the promises that we are worthy and loved and enough, then other people may not always be happy about that.
Not because
they don't love you, not because they don't care for you, but because you will no longer be the person that they knew before. And change, this fire of change that burns on the inside of us through the Spirit of God, can make us and other people uncomfortable. And this is where divisions may occur. This is where separations may happen. But even in that process, the Holy Spirit is aware of all the needs of all the people involved. And so we are called on to trust God in that journey of growing more fully into who we are made to be in Christ. We are asked to hold fast in that moment, as we read so beautifully today from Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 to 3. We are called on to run with patience and endurance the race that is set before us. Looking to all the heroes around us, not only of Scripture, but people that we know who have endured and held fast and received that wonderful blessing of the glory of God in their lives. We are called on to follow Jesus. We are called on to hold fast to the faith and that journey that seeks to lead us into a new reality, into a fresh relationship with one another. And this process that God desires is not just for us as individuals. It is for a whole society. It is for the whole created order. And we read this in the Psalms, that God will take each nation as God's own precious possession. And so the journey that each one of us are on, the grappling, the moving from fear to faith, the fire, the division, and the discernment, is a journey that we undertake so that the kingdom of God may come. It is a journey that we undertake as a people of God, and each one of us carries a responsibility to minister to the one next to us, to encourage and to help us each take a step on that journey of faith. I want to end with something that I hope will help us as we move into this week. It's an invitation. It's a version of the Serenity Prayer. And it's a version that Jean actually gave me 3 years ago. As we move into this week, and as we are opening our lives to that fire of change in us, and aware of how that may interact with those around us, I offer the Serenity Prayer. This version goes, God, grant me the serenity to accept the people I cannot change. God, grant me the serenity to accept the